It's the day of your GCSE science exam, and you open up the paper to see questions you have never seen before and not knowing how to answer them. Surely this would automatically put you on the back foot, right? And not make you as confident. That is why we have tried to make predictions about what will come up in this year's GCSE combined science for all of the paper ones. And we also want to give you some notes based on mark schemes from previous years so you know exactly what to write down if these sort of questions do come up. For biology, I think something about specialized cells will come up, so make sure you know the examples of these and also their functions and structures. Screenshot the notes on the screen here to help you prepare. They could also ask you to explain the process by which new skin cells form. These are some of the points that could be there based on previous mark schemes. Cancer would be another topic which would be very important to prepare for, so here are some summarized notes for that. If they ask you how a cancer drug can be formed, then make sure you learn this model answer on the screen now. This is from the mark schemes and it could be very similar to what comes up again. In terms of required practicals, of course, make sure you know all of them, but some important ones especially that could come up is the one about photosynthesis, osmosis, oxygen, and investigating enzyme reactions. The one about testing antibiotics on a petri dish also comes up quite often, so keep an eye out for that one also. In terms of chemistry, make sure you know how to draw the electronic structure, and also make sure that you're practicing how to draw dot and cross diagrams, especially for the common molecules that could come up. Ensure that you know the difference between endothermic and exothermic reactions. Your homework for the comment section is I want someone to write down what the difference between endothermic and exothermic reactions are. So go to the comments if you want to know the answer to that. In this topic also, especially make sure that you know the reaction profile diagrams. Make sure that you're practicing how to draw them from memory and not just looking over it in your revision guide. It makes a big difference on your ability to be able to draw it in the exam. And you don't want to waste time in the exam second guessing if you're drawing it correctly. So just practice drawing it 3 or 4 times out before the exam and that should be good. Electrolysis is also an important topic to be well versed on. Make sure you know that it means splitting up by electricity. Make sure you're able to draw and label a rough diagram and know the process of it. So here are some notes that are going to be vital for you. Make sure you also practice the half equations and have a system in your head for how you're going to tackle these questions. So let me know if you've got any advice for these sort of questions as well. If, for example, a 3, 4, or 6 mark question comes up about graphite versus diamond, I also think this will come up on the triple science paper, but here are some points that you should be learning and make sure that you put down if a comparison question like this does come up. Topics such as separation techniques, acids and bases, quantitative chemistry, and different types of bonding are also very important for you to be strong on. In terms of physics, make sure you screenshot and learn all of these circuit diagrams and practice drawing them. They could easily be a one mark question, or your knowledge of identifying one of them could be vital in completing a longer answer question. They could also ask you to describe an experiment to which you end up working out an IV graph. If this is the case, then here are some collated mark scheme points for a potential 6 mark question. As I said with the triple science paper as well, I believe the national grid, AC and DC, as well as step up and step down transformers could come up. It is possible that they ask you a direct question about why transformers are important in the national grid, so here are some points for you to learn. Also ensure that you know different types of energy and what they mean, such as thermal, kinetic, gravitational potential, elastic potential, chemical, magnetic, electrostatic, and nuclear energy. Ensure you're well versed on all of your definitions, and especially don't mix up specific latent heat and specific heat capacity. Specific latent heat is the energy required to change the state of 1 kg of a substance, and specific heat capacity is the energy required to increase the temperature of 1 kg of a substance by 1 degree Celsius. The best thing that you can do if you want to see me continuing to make videos like this is to smash the like button and subscribe, and let me know in the comments what you think of this video if you found it helpful. Also, let me know what you think is going to come up and if you've got any tips for this paper and any advice for anyone watching. The link is in the video description for affordable one-to-one and group session tuition, and I'll catch you on the next video. Thanks for watching.